गुड इवनिंग रेस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर मंगेश पाटे, पेट्रन आईएमए डोमली, आर पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट्स, सीनियर मेंबर्स, ऑल आईएमए मेंबर्स, अ वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम। इट इज एन ऑनर एंड प्रिविलेज टू बिकम द ब्रांच प्रेसिडेंट इन दिस गोल्डन जुबली ईयर। द थीम इन गोल्डन जुबली ईयर इज सेलिब्रेटिंग हेल्थ केयर एंड ह्यूमैनिटी। द गोल्डन स्टार इज आवर सिंबल। दिस विल ब्रिंग अस लक एंड कीप अस ऑल सेफ। I remember a famous Turkish proverb: "Life is what you are busy planning, and what happens to you is what destiny has in mind." It is challenging to become president and be a part of the task force in this pandemic situation. I have mixed feelings of fear and courage to fight this pandemic with all of you as frontline workers. This is my first address as a president. As I said, I'm speaking to you in challenging times, a time of disruption in our life that has brought grief to some, financial difficulties and enormous challenges in daily life. The Epidemic Act and Disaster Management Act was invoked by the center in March. We had a good start when our immediate past president, Dr. Meena Pruthi, and 25 volunteers joined us COVID warriors. We started our respiratory OPD in Shastri Nagar Hospital. The coronavirus had then brought a change in the public mindset regarding doctors. It changed the image. They were looking at doctors with respect again. The frontline workers were appreciated by clapping all over India. Many illustrations featuring doctors as soldiers and fighters protecting from the virus were seen, protecting the people from the virus. There were some incidences of violence against doctors, which our IMA national team took care of. They also had an ordinance passed against this violence. But when the doctors were evicted from the hospitals, IMA had meetings with the authorities and resolved it. At all levels, IMA were in constant meetings with health ministers and have brought our hospitals and nursing homes under MSME. The KDMC started sending a lot of official letters to our private hospitals, collecting the data of our staff, RMOs, ward boys, ventilators. They were preparing for the surge in COVID cases and were planning to use all our nursing homes. As a step to control the spread of virus in the community and protect our doctors from being quarantined, community clinics, the fever OPDs were started. The concept by IMA Domli Task Force team chairperson Dr. Archana Patil. Dr. Meena Pruthi as co-chair of the task force and Dr. Neeti Upasani, convener of the task force, were constantly on their toes in this dynamic situation. IMA Domli was approached and our members started giving their services at the behest of KDMC Honorary Commissioner. There were many training sessions for our members who were enthusiastically attending all the OPDs, which will continue and which are still ongoing. We had excluded the members, senior members above 60, but Dr. Dilip Kopade, Dr. Bakul Patil, Dr. Pramod Bahekar, they volunteered and have done community clinic duties. Dr. Nilima Date and Dr. Alka Gadgil have been diligently helping our Honorary Secretary Dr. Hemant Patil and Honorary Treasurer Dr. Vijay Chinchole in this work. The task force is constantly trying to coordinate last minute changes, unavailability of PPE, making reports for these community clinics. And there was a lot of appreciation of this work of IMA Domli on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, e-news. When the COVID war started, there was shortage of PPE, sanitizers. So all this was procured by the task force, N95, HCQ, hypochlorite cans, in liaison with the state authorities for bulk orders. We have our members stepped up and we received donations from Dr. Archana Patel and Dr. Mangesh Patel for infrared thermometers and pulse oximeter for all the community OPDs, and also they donated PPEs and N95 masks. As a task force, we also donated sanitizer cans and hypochlorite cans to all the police stations. Many of our members paid the AMC annual maintenance charges very promptly. We started a COVID fund and there were generous donations by our members, Dr. Umesh Date, Dr. Subhash Gadgil, Dr. Dilip Joshi, Dr. Sheetal Sagade, Dr. Jayant Gokhale, भोसले, डॉक्टर सती हरदे, डॉक्टर दादा साहेब धड़स, डॉक्टर महेंद्र कामत, डॉक्टर सीमा शानबाग, डॉक्टर रामनाथन अय्यर, डॉक्टर सुशीला अरविंदन, डॉक्टर अरुणा नायक देसाई, द इनर व्हील थ्रू बाय डॉक्टर अनुसिया गोपाल एंड अंजना पराशर ऑल्सो डोनेटेड एंड बाय मिस उषा आचार्य. It is a very proud moment when our own Dr. Vijaya Lakshmi Shinde as a microbiologist was invited by KDMC and she has drafted SOP for the housing societies and establishments in KDMC. As these community clinics further we had the next step, KDMC informed us about RR Hospital and Shastri Nagar Hospital to make it as the DCHC. So in lieu with that, Dr. Archana, myself, Dr. Meena and Dr. Neeti, we were given an official letter to visit Kasturba Hospital to learn. I remember the day. We all four were so tense, our families more tense, and we felt that when we are going into a lion's den, we carried the PPEs. We were so scared that we'll come back infected. And we reached Kasturba. We expected everybody to be in these PPE suits, but actually it was so normal atmosphere, and everybody was in a simple mask, which was their PPE. We saw the triage areas in Kasturba, the suspects, the positive wards, the PCR lab. We understood the concepts of HIC and the central guidelines, and we were then a bit relaxed. And then we, after understanding these protocols, it took 3 weeks to make the KDMC implement in RR Hospital. The gap analysis done, ventilation expert for the cycle changes, and involving the HIC expert. IMA Domli had the honorary commissioner involved in and getting all this implemented. We had so many innumerable meetings, the task force, managing committee, and the only one intention that if our members go in, it has to be safe. We had 2 groups of task force, one for RR and one for Shastri Nagar. And soon our specialists, anesthesian and physicians, anesthesiologists were met, the meetings were held, WhatsApp groups were formed, they were briefed, and we started the honorary rota duties. The anesthesiologist started when the ICU was ready with the HIC and ventilation assessment and quality control measures. We had still lots of lacunae, and the task force in liaison with these anesthesiologists and physicians were constantly trying to resolve them, to improve the availability of pathology, the turnaround times, good PPE, ECG machines. And I really salute the anesthesiologists. They had been doing the most dangerous procedure of intubating critical ill patients in ICU. And our respectable physicians were managing almost 50 to 55 patients daily. They make our branch proud, and they're still doing it, wearing the PPE, taking rounds for almost 4 to 5 hours. There are no words to express the great service which our branch physicians and anesthesiologists are giving to mankind. I also would like to appreciate all our doctors as they continue with the non-COVID work, constantly treating and guiding patients. The doctors, against all our odds, with staff at 30% attendance, had kept their hospitals open. The senior practitioners continue to help the patients by telemedicine. Few of our doctors became corona positive, Dr. Sudhir Mistry and Dr. Pallavi Mistry. They have successfully recovered, and I'm very happy to say that they have started and resumed their practice. Dr. Karwa is recovered, and he is now still in quarantine. These all our doctors have been contributing to this COVID and non-COVID work morally and ethically. They have responsibility of the patient, society, their own staff and family. Our members are taking care of the physical and mental health of patients and society. I want to thank all IMA doctors as frontline workers who selflessly continue their duties in COVID and non-COVID. I also want to thank those of you who are staying home, thereby helping to protect the vulnerable. Corona has taken our endurance to a next level. It has caused a lot of stress, professional, economic, health, family stress, with fear of catching the infection, which may cause a major disruption and disaster to our family. We'll remain together to tackle this disease, and in years to come, we will be able to take pride in how we responded to the challenge. The COVID war started in March, and it may still continue for a few months ahead. But we are all in this war together and we'll emerge victorious. All said and done, it was a cherishable moment when the first batch of COVID patients were treated and cured and discharged from both RR and Shastri Nagar Hospital. As we continue with these rota, we had a comorbidity committee which comprised of 4 senior physicians, 1 senior anesthesiologist and 1 senior orthopedic surgeon. And they helped us with the exemption criteria, thereby safeguarding our colleagues who may be of high risk if inadvertently exposed. The greatest feather in cap of IMA Dombivli was the MOU. It was drafted by the COVID task force and we are the first branch to have it signed with the MOH. This MOU includes points of treatment of our doctors if he or she unfortunately contracts the virus and becomes positive. And of course, getting treatment at their hospital of choice and payment of the charges upfront. As the cases surge, the government is making the doctors scapegoats look bad. There are daily news about clinics being shut, exorbitant hospital bills, patients being turned away, capping of charges. And there are lots of threatening of doctors at various angles. It is time that IMA and KDMC bring a resolution to the problems at hand. Blaming the doctors for the failure of government health structure and the press giving us negative publicity is not in any ways helping treat and cure the patient. We need to have a plan for more COVID hospitals and isolation facilities for us doctors in Dombivli. IMA Dombivli needs to add hospitals with operation theater for ANC and surgical patients. We all should come together and foresee the future and have something dedicated for us doctors where we can, unfortunately, if it happens, we should have these facilities. Dr. Mangesh Pate, our branch patron and national leader, has helped the task force navigate in these stormy waters. He has been applauded for many interviews on Mirror Now with Faye D'Souza. I have the past presidents as a guiding force with their knowledge and experience, Dr. Neeti Upasani, Dr. Archana Pate, Dr. Meena Pruthi, and they in their consecutive years have brought innovations and taken us to great heights. Inspired by them and their guidance, we'll continue to march forward. I have my honorary secretary, Dr. Hemant Patil, and honorary treasurer, Dr. Vijay Chinchole, giving me the 100% all the time. Vice President Dr. Sunit Upasani, President-elect Dr. Bhakti Lote, Dr. Vijay Lakshmi Shinde are steady support, helping with social media. I salute all IMA Dombivli members who are COVID warriors. They are wonderfully handling the community clinics and COVID hospitals in this ongoing pandemic. We are all exhausted by the daily COVID news, the rising numbers, the inadequacy of health infrastructure, the hopelessness and the fear and despair. I request all of you to take care of your physical and mental health. Give time to your family. It is a time to pause and reboot. At juncture, I would say that Dr. Archana Pate, our chairperson of scientific committee, has achieved a great success in Golden Jubilee year by getting us the sanction for zero study of healthcare workers of IMA Dombivli. This is in association with ICMR and NIH. And this study of SARS-CoV-2 IgG antibody by COVID Kavach ELISA test. And as we continue, the first time we are using the digital platform and we'll be continuing this for the activities further for a few months. And in this Golden Jubilee year, we had lots of plans for celebrating many programs. We also had the Women's Wing celebrate the Family Day. We had a WHO program. HBI had kept a meeting with Honorary Commissioner and Dr. Pate, where all the hospital owners' problems were solved. This golden star is our symbol. It will bring us luck. And we'll continue doing projects. Thank you. Thank you for patiently listening to me. I now hand over to Honorary Secretary, Dr. Hemant Pate.
Thank you, Madam. Thank you for an excellent speech and covering the tremendous work done by all the IMA members in a very short time. It is really difficult to cover the work done by all of us. but you did it excellently. Now, as we know, COVID-19 is a very dynamic situation. We have to keep ourselves updated every day. It is changing every moment. And to tell us what is the current scenario of COVID-19 around us, we have our own national leader, Dr. Mangesh Pate. He is a member of National Task Force. He is a chairman of Hospital Board of India, IMA Maharashtra State, treasurer, HBI, IMA headquarters, and he doesn't need any other introduction. So I invite Dr. Mangesh Pate sir to please come and give a speech on COVID-19 current scenario.
Thank you, Hemant. I hope I am audible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Respected President, Madam, Dr. Vandana, respected Honorable Secretary, Dr. Hemant, Finance Secretary, Dr. Vijay, all past branch presidents, and my brothers and sisters from IIM Dombivli. Today, I congratulate the President, Secretary, and the entire Managing Committee for conducting this meeting, first of all. What I have been asked to speak on the scenario, COVID-19 scenario today, what it is. I will divide it into two things. What actually is there outside? What should be the IMA response in very short? And what are people, our members, they are supposed to take? The third point about our members, I am slightly worried. I am pained. Really, I am worried about our all IIM Dombivli members because of certain things which I will put forth in my speech. First of all, as far as COVID-19 picture, what we see around us, I did not tell anyone. We are seeing how nonsense is going on everywhere. Right from the central government, state government, till the local civic body level, everyone is discussing, still they are in their own mode of denial that there is no community transmission. Not a single day they have been successful in tracing the origin of any case, infection in any case. And when you fail to trace the origin of the infection in any positive case, what you find, it is the beginning of the community transmission. And this we are noticing in hundreds of cases every day, that local civic body is failing to trace the origin of infection, where it is coming from in all cases, which they are declaring it to be positive every day. Every day we are reading it is something in 550, 570, 580, something like that is happening. They just declare the figures. Now, what action is being taken by them on the new cases every day which is coming? That is not known. And I have got my 110% doubt. When you get 550 cases positive, how much functioning is needed behind the curtain? How much workup is needed behind the curtain to trace the origins of these cases so that we can contain the transmission to some extent? I am saying again to some extent, which I 100% doubt, because when we were seeing the cases in 30, 35, 37, 40, that time also there was a problem of tracing, contact tracing and containing the people. Right now we are in the 550, 560 this year, and I'm 100% sure there will be no tracing at all. So this back behind the curtain work where civic body is totally failing. Now, it is as per the how the government functions that are functioning is happening. And we definitely cannot 100% correct, take any corrective measures, what how the suddenly KDMC will start functioning very properly. That is not possible. But as the Indian Medical Association, if you see at national headquarters, if you see at a state level, if you see at a few branch levels, the role of Indian Medical Association is always to give a proper professional suggestions to the local civic body and the government. when you see the functioning of the IMA headquarters, whenever any issues are coming, proper advices, advisory is always suggested and given to the central government. It is a different thing. How much they listen to you and how much they conduct or carry on with your suggestions, that is a different thing. But we, as a professional association, should not fail in giving our suggestions to the government. As far as Dombivli is concerned, TDMC is our local civic body. Every day when we see something is going wrong, please write it down in very short and precise way what the issue is there and what are the problems and solutions we think for the issue. It should be given to the TDMC. You should always have a copy, CC of what you have submitted to the TDMC, so that tomorrow something goes wrong, you have got to say that as a professional association, we had given these suggestions. That is something very immediately needed to be given today. For that matter, our president, I am very proud on the central admission. She has very properly put the problems there. It was a fearless step by her. And I immediately supported her, what she has given. What if you see on today's central group, they have put the guidelines. They do not carry any meaning. If you see the guidelines which we released 3.5 months back, it has got everything. And I requested Dr. Archana to put it immediately so that KDMC entire self knows what our branch is doing, that no one can remember that. We have achieved everything. What today problems they are seeing, we have foreseen those problems 3.5 months back and we have given the solution. The era where it was possible for us to act, we have acted upon and we have completed the work. So, as far as the professional association, the branch always should give the professional suggestions and advisory to the local civic body, and you should have a copy with you. Whether they listen to you, whether they do not listen to you, just leave it to them. Don't think of that. Go on giving the suggestion. Don't stop. Second thing is that, as far as my members are concerned, I said I am very worried. Let me tell you, every day, I am receiving minimum one phone call. Minimum, I am saying, one phone call from our member that he or she has turned positive or they are having some symptoms. This is going on so rampant. And I, on the rough way, I can estimate nearly 20-25 members or members of IMA Dombivli have turned out positive now. They have taken treatment, got cured, or they are under treatment, whatever phase they are into it. I want to tell all members here, be utmost careful. You are in the community transmission area. There are two places you have to be very careful about. First is in your own private practice. What experience I am having whenever I am receiving the phone calls, people are asking for advice is, what experience I am getting, certain things are not being followed by our members. That is causing problem for them. Like when you are sitting in your OPD, the minimum possible mask, proper mask and face shield is must. To avoid the community transmission or fomite transmission, repeated sanitization of your hands, cleaning of your hands is very much necessary. Whenever you are getting any patients, in your OPD, in your IPD, please always think that every patient is a COVID patient. Today's scenario is like that, and treat that patient accordingly and take care of yourself. That is most important. Some plus or minus is happening and our people are falling prey and are getting infected. This is point number one. As far as our professional places are concerned, be extremely careful. And I will give you advisory for next 60 days. Mind you, next 2 months are extremely crucial. The way our governance is functioning here, we all are staying in the same community. So you and me, we are not going to be able to safeguard ourselves to much of an extent unless we take utmost care of ourselves. That is most important. And second, my humble request to everyone, I have noticed this in many people. They are contacting us very, very late. Very late. Please don't do it. Whenever you have got anything, even if midnight, 2 o'clock, please give us a call. Any of the managing committee, IMA Dombivli, myself, Archana, We all are ready to help you 24/7. But please do not delay in reporting your symptoms. I have seen few people, they are telling us that they have become positive and they are fine at home after 4 to 5 days of reporting. And then when we advise them, they don't act upon that. And after a couple of days, we have got a report that they have noted their own SpO2 at home, 75. Please do not do this. Whenever you are getting mildest of the symptom, please report to us. Please call us any time of the day. Please call us. If we do not pick up your call, we may be in the ICU, we may be busy in the somewhere. Give call after some time. Leave a message on our mobile. Contact any of the managing committee member. But the entire managing committee of IIM Dombivli is standing for our own members. So it's my humble request. Do not make even a single minute delay in reporting if at all you get any symptoms. Once you report early, we will be able to take some provide you some professional help. And when you treat this COVID in early phases, I assure you, nothing goes wrong. So many cases we have treated now. Those who are treating physicians, they will agree with you. When you interfere in early stages, you get extremely good results. Extremely good results. And very specifically, those really have comorbidity or those who are above 60 years of age, you should be more careful during this pandemic era. I just request all of you again with folded hand, please take care of yourself. We all are there for you. Don't think IIM Dombivli sitting idle. We are there to take care. So many doctors we have helped. Let me tell you here point blank. So many doctors, not only IIM Dombivli, from outside also, numerous doctors we have helped. We have helped so many Ayush people when they have contacted with the infection. So we will stand definitely for our own branch people. So do not become late in reporting the whatever you are having symptom, whether your test is done, whether your test is not done. If you get symptoms, please report. I thank again IIM Dombivli President, Secretary, and entire Managing Committee, and all my friends who gave me this chance. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you again for a wonderful speech, always talking about ground reality problems and providing solutions for them. And now we have seen how deadly the COVID-19 is becoming. It has come to our doorstep. Now to reduce the mortality, we must know what early steps can be taken against the COVID-19. Some early steps can really save the precious lives. To tell us more about, I am inviting Dr. Archana Pate, eminent physician from Dombivli, chairperson IIM Dombivli Task Force and executive member of MMC, to tell us about early intervention in COVID-19 to reduce the mortality. I think
Hemant, just
I'll just see, madam. I think she got disconnected. Some network issue might be there. I'll just try to fix.
Okay, am I audible?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So it is. These are like novices trying to get into the digital mode. So for that. National leader Dr. Mangesh Pate, dear President Dr. Vandana, Dr. Hemant, Dr. Vijay, IPP Dr. Meena, Dr. Neeti, Dr. Bhakti, and all my dear friends from Managing Committee and from IIM Dombivli. This is absolutely fantastic. Gloomy days ahead, but you know, to get together with our friends on digital platform, it is like really a good thing. and thank you, IIM Dombivli, for finding out something like this. I have been given a topic to talk on reducing the mortality in COVID-19 era. As Dr. Mangesh Patel rightly said, it is at our doorstep and spreading like wildfire. So it's like the doctors are coming, so many number of doctors are coming positive, and so many patients contact for help that it is really heartbreaking when you're not even able to help probably say 5% of them. But we try our level best to provide as good help as we can. So there are certain things I think we all now need to take into our daily practice, because COVID is here to stay. I think the government tried its level best to give the idea that lockdown is going to be the ultimate solution for bringing down the numbers or taking care of COVID. But we all as clinicians know that no, that is not the way out. The whole idea of lockdown was probably to make ourselves more medically capable, but unfortunately that has not happened. The medical facilities have remained the same, maybe increased in some way, but we are still lacking medical facilities in a lot of way. So for reducing the numbers, what we need is, I have tried to put it into three headings. One is prevention, second is early recognition, and third is the treatment aspect. Prevention, basically, this is a viral infection, to which it is a novel virus, to which none of us has been exposed before, and so we do not have any immunity towards it. What we can do to improve our immunity is probably going to help us in, there is nothing that we are not going to contract the virus. We will, we may, but probably if we improve our immune system, the infection may be, limited to a milder variety. So what I need to suggest is that, there are certain things we need to do or we may undertake in our daily routine, like certain breathing exercises daily. Learn pranayam, learn omkar chanting, some ujjayi breaths. There are online art of living classes which are available. You can attend that and you can make yourself aware of the technique of breathing. Basically, it stimulates your parasympathetic nervous system. It improves tissue oxygenation, increases your energy levels, detoxifies the body, decreases inflammation. Inflammatory reaction in the cytokine storm period is like one of the worst phases during COVID infection, which we see during the 8th to 12th day probably of the symptomatic period. So it helps to bring down the inflammation, detoxifies the body, stimulates the lymphatic system, and relaxes mind and body. We should do something to boost our immunity, increase your fruit and vegetable intake, exercise daily, as I said, do breathing exercises, quit smoking and alcohol, have good sleep, and try to bring down your stress levels. Everybody needs to control comorbidities, because the comorbid patients are seen to have maximum impact of COVID. If you are a diabetic, you are a hypertensive, you have any COPD, asthma, you please try to control it as best as you can. This goes without saying, mask, hand sanitizer, social distancing. I think even every lay person knows about it. So I don't think we as doctors, we can emphasize this enough. When we are in the OPD, we need to be really, really careful. As Dr. Patel rightly said, in community transmission, we are in major community transmission mode. We need to take every patient that comes to us as a potential suspect unless proven otherwise. And there is no way we can prove it otherwise. So please take every patient who's entering your OPD as a potential COVID person. You take care of yourself. I have issued many guidelines. I'm going to be really brief over here. Keep your area well ventilated. Teach your staff triaging. Your staff, you should be using proper PPEs, your N95 cap, gown, double gloves, face shield. This goes without saying. I think you just need to do it. Please remember, you are in an OPD for only 4 hours, 5 hours. Rest 20 hours, you are not in your OPD. What we see, what I have seen in majority of the patients, the masks start inducing some itching. And many of the people are in a habit of touching their nose and their mouth repeatedly because they get some sort of itchy feeling and something crawling under their nose. Please stop this habit of touching your nose and mouth area repeatedly. One of the worst carriers of infection where you can potentially get infected. All healthcare workers, unless they have any cardiac issues or on beta blockers, need to do their ECG. Whatever the other studies may say, the solidarity study, and they say that HCQS has no role. But please believe that ICMR still sticks to HCQS prophylaxis in healthcare workers. So all healthcare workers need to be on HCQS prophylaxis. Do steam inhalation 3 times a day and do warm saline gargles at least 3 times a day if you can. You can do some mouthwash with, say, Listerine. You can do it, or Betadine mouthwash would help. So basically, this is all about, you know, taking care of yourself so that you don't catch the infection. But what happens when you catch the infection? There's a lot of fear. There's a lot of anxiety. And what we see, Vihan, can you please stop that? What we see is that people are running away, or people are shying away, or people are getting scared in getting themselves tested for COVID. I'll tell you only certain advantages of getting tested yourself for COVID and knowing your COVID status. One is that you know your status, so it's a known enemy. Once it's a known enemy, however brilliant you may be, how many ever indications you may get, how many CT findings you may get, but you know, there is always a thought lurking at the back of your mind that what if I'm COVID negative? What if I'm doing the wrong thing? Know your COVID positive status. Suspects are finding it very, very hard to find a hospital bed. Okay, so your COVID status is going to help you a lot in case of an unfortunate event that you need to look out for a hospital bed. Even for healthcare workers, it is proving to be a very, very difficult task. So please know your COVID status. Anybody coming to you, or you yourself, anybody having fever, even if it is low grade, for more than 48 hours, just go and straight away get a COVID test done. Any features of viremia which you feel are really severe, or they're lasting for more than 48 hours, lot of body ache, lot of fatigue, you know, malaise, soreness of throat, please go and get your COVID testing done. Recognize your COVID positivity earlier on so that you know from which day to count your number of days, because there is a certain period where complications are very, very well known. So you can time your symptoms and you can be ready in case some problem was to occur. Now, when you are at home, we are talking about reducing the mortality. What you should be doing if you know your COVID positive status, you need to be monitoring your saturation regularly, every 4 hourly. You need to do walk test. Okay, your saturation ideally should be above 96, 97. You need to do your walk test, that is walk, you know, at a normal pace for about 5 to 6 minutes and immediately check your saturation. If your saturation is dropping by 2 or 3, your walk test is considered as positive. Immediately seek help. Okay, there are certain red flag investigations which you can do at designated intervals. Do them. Know where is, because these red flag investigations basically tell you that what are the chances of you going into complications. So if your red flag investigations are all, you know, raising a red flag, by all means, please seek an expert help. Any breathlessness, any drop in saturation, what we are seeing, what our patients have reported, is there is an occasional drop in saturation. You know, in the night when they get up for bathroom or something, they'll see that saturation has dropped to 94. In the daytime, they're doing the normal duty, the normal activity, saturation is 96, 97. Suddenly, they'll say one point time, the pulse ox was not recording properly. The battery was low. My hands were cold. I had washed my hands. I'd just gone to the bathroom. But the saturation recorded was 90. These are not probably false readings. You know, there are occasional very small episodes of hypoxia coming, which may be recorded on pulse ox, and the saturation then comes back to normal. These are your early markers where you really, really, really need to seek help. Do HRCT at regular time intervals. Please seek help, because earlier you seek help, earlier you start treatment, earlier you recognize the red flag signs and get hospitalized, and you are started on a correct form of treatment, the lesser the chances of complications are. So please, please, please seek help very early. And I say only one thing. We are in a situation which is like never before, and we are never going to see it in the next 100 years, and where we are not going to be there. So if you do not seek help now, I do not know when you are going to be seeking help. Okay, so these are basically what you're supposed to do when you recognize that you have got COVID positivity. Treatment wise, if you are at home, as I said, you know, there are certain antivirals which you can take at home. Again, it depends on your level of the infectivity or the level of your symptoms which you are having. Everybody is not treated in a similar manner. So you need to be really, really, really be able to describe your symptoms well in detail. One thing I wish to say, that suspects are the ones who are facing majority of the problem. Suspect patients who are having all CORAD scores 4, 5, 6 on CT scans, but they are having, you know, their COVID reports are unknown. Even if the red flag markers are elevated, they are breathless, nobody takes them. Believe me, nobody takes them. There are two or three hospitals which are taking them. How much ever hard we try, the number of beds are limited. So it's my sincerest appeal to members of IMA Dombivli who are hospital owners to sincerely think of, you know, opening up their facilities for patients who are COVID suspects. We in our own way, in our own community, will be able to, you know, bring down the mortality levels by giving more support to the patients. We are there to guide. So anybody wishes to do this, please do come forward. Let us know. We will guide for infection control. We will guide for treatment criteria, and we will guide all the way out. So please, please, please open up your hospitals for COVID suspects. Treatment wise, there is nothing which I can tell you beyond, you know, the patient is at home, because once the patient goes to the hospital, they may need high flow oxygen, they may need HFNO, they may need NIV. Antivirals are not of much help, besides a few where every second day, third day, you see CDC is, you know, removing one line of treatment, WHO is not standing by another line of treatment. So there is tremendous confusion there. What worries us is only the cytokine storm and probably the patient later going in ARDS, or the patient landing up in sepsis and probably septic shock. If these things are timed correctly, treated correctly, yes, patients can have a pretty good outcome. We have a problem of procuring the medicines. Tocilizumab is not available. Remdesivir is not available freely. These are the problems which really the government needs to sort out at their level. And we really hope that by 10th or 12th, we have been told that remdesivir production is going to begin by Cipla and Hetero, and we will be having it available in more numbers. But till then, what I really need to stress and emphasize is certain take-home messages. One, seek help early. Second, know your COVID positivity status early. Whatever anybody says, know your COVID positivity status early. It helps you in securing admission if the time be. Please understand how to monitor if you become COVID positive. If there are red flag signs, if there is any drop of saturation, please, please, please seek help early. And we should and open up your hospitals for suspects. And I think we should be able to help our own selves and our community in a large way to bring down the mortality. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much. It was a very informative lecture. I think leaving the stigma, shy, accepting the facts, and asking for early help can save our precious lives. Thank you, madam, for a wonderful lecture. Now, coming back to our theme of Atma Samman. Now, this is a time where we have to acknowledge and appreciate all our members who have fought like warriors in this COVID-19 fight. To do the honors, I'll call upon Dr. Neeti Upasani. She's a chairperson of Cultural Committee IMA Dombivli, and Dr. Vijayalakshmi Shinde, convener of Cultural Committee IMA Dombivli, to carry forward the session. I call upon Dr. Neeti Upasani.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good evening, Dr. Mangesh Pate, patron IMA Dombivli, President Dr. Vandana Dhaktode, Honorary Secretary Dr. Heman Patil, all past presidents of Dombivli, and my dear Dombivli friends. It indeed is a joyous moment to at least meet everyone on this virtual platform. And I thank Dr. President Vandana Madam for giving me the opportunity to chair the Cultural Committee Dombivli in this Golden Jubilee year. Friends, this is our Golden Jubilee year. And when the new team was planning the function, and when new team was planning activities for Golden Jubilee, we had lined up a galaxy of many projects, but COVID had its own mind and things are on hold for the moment. And each year, Doctor's Day is one of the most important celebration for us as a family event, where we celebrate our profession and family felicitations. Our recognition of doctors with 25 years of service, students' felicitation for academic and extracurricular achievements, and much more is awaited, and it will be done with a pomp. And it will be done with a pomp, and it is a promise. Jocelyn Soriano, she is a famous inspirational writer. She said, "Let no momentary storm, no matter however strong, ever it darken your hope." And we have hope in abundance for the future. So Corona has not deterred our spirit of celebration. And here we are having a virtual celebration. Each year our Doctor's Day theme is given by IIM Maharashtra State. And this year's theme is Atma Samman Divas. Gharchya mandalini kya paathivar dileli kautukachi thap aste. Ti kharakharach manapasun dileli aste. आणि एकदा कधीतरी गॅलरीत उभे राहून दिलेल्या टाळ्या आणि थाळ्या यापेक्षा ही कौतुकाची थाप नेहमीच मोलायची असं नाही का. आणि म्हणूनच आज आपण आपल्या सगळ्यांचीच कौतुकाने पाठ थापवणार आहोत. बरं, विल बी फेलिसिटिंग ऑल द कोविड वॉरियर्स विथ ई सर्टिफिकेट्स. बट हॅज एनीवन वंडर्ड वाय द टर्म वॉरियर अँड नथिंग एल्स? आर वी ट्रेंड एज वॉरियर्स? ऑब्व्हियसली नॉट. But still we are applauded as one because, as a famous American novelist Mark Manson said, bravery is not the absence of fear. Bravery is feeling the fear, the doubt, the insecurity, and still deciding that something else is more important. And for us doctors, the fear of COVID for self and our family constantly is at back of our mind. Still, our professional and humanitarian commitment towards the patients has taken a priority and we have become true warriors. So let's begin the felicitation. The first category is for community clinics. We will first felicitate the doctors who participated in community fever clinics and are still doing so daily. Nipping the problem in the bud is essential to decrease the spread of the disease. And our expert doctors like general physicians, specialists, and super specialists manage these OPDs to identify the patient so diagnosis can be done early. And the contribution of more than 180 of our members is really praiseworthy. And we should applaud each and every one of them with this Corona Warrior certificate. We are now showing some of the certificates, e-certificates, as sample, and we will be issuing these certificates to everyone who has participated in the community clinics. I thank Dr. Vijayalakshmi for taking efforts to make the PPT and all the certificates. The second category is physicians. Friends, fear has two meanings. Forget everything and run, or face everything and rise. And our physicians have chosen to rise. Working in wards and ICU with so many COVID patients, viral load in the atmosphere where you are entering, unavailability of medicines and much needed equipment due to shortcomings from KDMC, etc. But still they did their rota and successfully treated many patients both in RR and Sasrinagar Hospital. And we salute them by e-certificate. Here are certain few certificates to show. The next category we move on is anesthesiologist. My anesthetist friends were at the maximum risk working in ICU for procedures. Their anxiety was almost palpable. But they have shown courage as a true soldier. In World War II, US Army Commander Omar Bradley had said, "Bravery is the capacity to perform properly even when you are scared half to the death." And all our anesthesia colleagues deserve a standing ovation for doing their duties, and they have delivered their duties. And thank you, friends. I bow to you. These are certain anesthesia certificates. We have many certificates, so I'm going pretty fast. Now we have moved on to our next category of recognition for exemplary work done in COVID pandemic. Dear friends, direct patient care was utmost important, but creating atmosphere for this work, establishing facilities from scratch, visiting facilities to learn to manage corona, laying the best foundation and protocols for HIC to have safest working atmosphere in present conditions, liaising with various authorities day and night, dealing with numerous daily changing government notifications and norms, safeguarding our members' interests by MOU, presenting our work done on various social platforms, keeping track of daily branch activities at various levels, dealing with many personal problems of our members while managing their own hospital and family really needs a true dedication to the fraternity. And all those need a special recognition. And here are our doctors who have done exemplary work done. The first, obviously, and without any doubt, is Dr. Mangesh Patel, National Task COVID Task Leader. And he has been guiding guide for everything done by IMA Dombivli for COVID management. And President Vandana has already mentioned his contribution to COVID. Sir, you are indeed an inspiration to us. And in future, I'm sure your writings, which are becoming awesome day by day, will be searched and quoted by Google as famous quotes by Dr. Mangesh Patel. Next, we felicitate Dr. Archana Patel as exemplary warrior for conceptualizing community clinic and protocol for management of COVID patients. Her training videos for community clinics were uploaded even by IMA Maharashtra State and headquarters. She was instrumental in setting up dedicated COVID hospitals as RR, including HIC protocols. And she is instrumental in first zero surveillance study of COVID in India approved by ICMR. And we are proud that in Dombivli we are going to conduct that study, all thanks to her. And she has done excellent work as physician in RR hospital and still continuing with that. Archana, salute to you. Next exemplary worker is Dr. Meena Pruthi, immediate past president. And in her tenure, the COVID work had started before Vandana took over. Meena was instrumental in starting fever clinics in Shastri Nagar, collaboration of all the task force, excellent work as physician in RR Hospital and Shastri Nagar Hospital both. And she has conducted HBI meeting to solve hospital owners' problems. Thank you, Meena.
Thank you, Dr. Neeti. Thank you so much.
Next is myself. Satasa Kautuk Karune. So I'll skip my. I am with all my COVID task force members doing all the activities and proud to be a member of task force and I am a Dombivli. So I congratulate myself on behalf of managing committee.
Congratulations, Neeti.
Thank you. Next is Dr. Bhakti Lote. Bhakti is part of task force. She is having giving her 100% to all the work which is done, and she is instrumental in managing the social media platform of IMA Dombivli, because whatever work we are doing, it is necessary that it is brought in front of the society, and Bhakti is working a lot for social media platform. Thank you, Bhakti. Congratulations. Next in line is Dr. Vijayalakshmi Shinde. Dr. Vijayalakshmi Shinde is appointed by KDMC, and she has prepared infection control guidelines for community for enabling non-clinical establishments to function during and post-lockdown for shops, police, media, chemists, banks, housing, vendors, officers, etc. and housing guidelines have been recorded by Maharashtra Society Welfare Association, and guidelines have been acknowledged and applauded in community and media. Congratulations, Viji, you have achieved a lot in such a young age. Next in line is Dr. Vijay Chinchole. Okay, Dr. Neelima Date. Dr. Neelima Date is instrumental in keeping the rota of all the four community clinics, and now we are having two community clinics continuously on. And that is a big task, calling up everyone daily, solving any problems. Then after the OPD, if there are any lacunae, to keep track of that and informing us about those lacunae. She is doing a tremendous work, and she is helped by Dr. Alka Gadge, who is the convener of WDW, and Neelima and Alka both, as WDW had got some other programs planned, they will be telling it sooner. Congratulations, Neelima and Alka both. Next in line is Dr. Vijay Chinchole, psychiatrist. Friends, we all know that these are gloomy times, and there is a rise in depression, the suicidal attempts, and violence in the family. And there was a psychiatry helpline which was established, and Dr. Vijay Chinchole was appointed from Kalyan Dombivli area. So it is a proud moment for us. And congratulations, Vijay, and he is essential part of task force as well as the treasurer. He is keeping all the records of the money which is received and spent. I just cannot forget Dr. Hemant Patil. Dr. Hemant Patil is a silent worker, one of the best finds for managing committee of IIMA Dombivli, I can say. It is a big task to keep the minutes of the innumerable minutes what we are having, the innumerable communication which we are having with all the authorities, to keep track of that, keeping track of all the rota of physicians, anesthetists, all the community clinics, and solving all the queries. And Hemant is doing it diligently and silently. And congratulations, Hemant, for it. You really deserve. And remember the words which I told you today.
Thank you.
Okay, I will need a treat if that happens.
Yes.
Next in line is Dr. Pramod Bahekar. Dr. Pramod Bahekar is a guru of managing committee of IIMA Dombivli, and he is always helping and guiding in every part of COVID work, let it be MOU, let it be rota. The problem arises and Dr. Bahekar steps in to solve them, and he had volunteered duty in spite of the age. I won't say his age, but he was exempted from the duties because of age, but he still volunteered to do the duty, and he did it. So congratulations, Bahekar sir. Then we will like to felicitate Dr. Deepa Shukla. Dr. Deepa Shukla is our own member who is diligently working in Shastri Nagar and was a help at a call away. She was just a call away for our members who were visiting Shastri Nagar Hospital, and she has been looking after Shastri Nagar Hospital day in and out. And Deepa, it's really hats off to you and your dedication. I know the situation is really bad in Shastri Nagar Hospital, but you're doing your duty and making IIMA Dombivli proud. So salute to you, Deepa, as well. The next in line for exemplary work done is Dr. Dilip Koparde and Dr. Bakul Patil. Both of them have done their duties in spite of being exempted from their duties as age criteria, but it did not deter them from giving their bit to the society, and they had volunteered, and IIMA Dombivli recognizes both Dr. Dilip Koparde and Dr. Bakul Patil for this volunteer duty, and we salute you both, sir. So there we conclude our exemplary certificates. Now we move on to our next category. It was, sir, a few of our doctors, actually many of us are doctors, but are in quarantine still, but were diagnosed as COVID, and they have successfully beat the disease and have resumed their hospital work immediately, and we salute them for their never say never attitude. Dr. Pallavi Misri, Dr. Sudhir Misri, Dr. Santosh Kohli, Dr. Karwa, Dr. Anjana Parashar. They resumed their duties. Others are still in quarantine, but they will be resuming their duties because the spirit is still on. Congratulations, everyone. The next category is representatives of resident doctors and government doctors. We have from IMADMB many of our own members and registered medical practitioners in our area who are giving services in various government hospitals or private hospitals taken over by government as DCH, like KDMC Hospital, RR Hospital, Wadia, Sayan, ESIS, NCMC, Navle Hospital, Seven Hills Hospital, Lilavati, Bethany, SRV, Kembur, to name the few. There are many more. A special mention is necessary of children of our own members who are doing internships or postgraduate work in various hospitals. And they are doing tremendous work because they are handling literally hundreds of patients at any given time. And here we will felicitate our members who are working for KDMC under ANUHM scheme as well. These are some of the names. If you have skipped or missed any names, do excuse us and do tell us. We like to include your names as well. The next category is deans or medical superintendent of government COVID hospital. We have our own Dr. Pratibha Savan, who is newly appointed as Dean Kalwa Hospital. And Pratibha is guiding Kalwa Hospital so well. And congratulations, Dr. Pratibha. We are proud of you. Next in line, district collectors, municipal commissioners, police commissioners, and other administrators of KDMC. Like us doctors, they also have stood continuously on their feet and managed other aspects of society which was disrupted due to lockdown and corona. And we felicitate all these administrative officers. And we begin with felicitation of Dr. Vijay Suryavanshi, who was with us from our first step in managing COVID disaster. And Dr. Vijay Suryavanshi has given us innumerable meetings and he has heard our problems. He has tried to solve them as much as possible. And we acknowledge his contribution and being our association with IMA Dombivli. Then in line is additional commissioner, the police department, the traffic police department, Dr. Supriya Ameya, who was appointed by KDMC as HIC expert, then MOA, then all the doctors like Dr. Samir Sarvankar, Dr. Pratibha Panpatil, Dr. Sandeep Nimbalkar, Dr. Suhasini Badekar, then Dr. Amir Qureshi and Bharat Tiwari of RR Hospital. We acknowledge all of them and there are many more. Friends, we move on to the next category, that is a comorbidity committee. Actually, when our work started, there were certain criteria which were given by government for exemption of duties. So we had a comorbidity committee formed and they gave their expert opinions for comorbidities of our own members for exempting them from the duties to maintain the transparency in branch proceedings. So, and we thank all six of them, Dr. Anil Chaudhary, Dr. Daga, Dr. Anil Deshe, Dr. Girish Gayavan, Dr. Jule, Srinivas Jule, and Dr. Smita Rode, madam. They had laid certain guidelines and accordingly they sorted out all the people who had given their comorbidity criteria. The last but not the least is donations. Winston Churchill said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give." And donations is one of the best service to society. And IMA Dombivli acknowledges all the donors from bottom of their heart who have donated so generously. And we bow to them for this generous gesture. You can see the names on the slide in front of you. Friends, with this, our first chapter of continuation of Doctors' Day celebration is being concluded. And stay tuned for many more activities which will be coming up soon. And thank you all. And Dr. Hemant, over to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, madam, for very encouraging words, and thank you for praising me for lovely words. Now today is an era of social media, so every one of us wants to be represented at social media. So we, our media team thought of an idea to celebrate the work done by every COVID warrior by presenting them with a warrior e-card. So I request our immediate past president, Dr. Meena Pruthi Madam, our president-elect, Dr. Bhakti Lote, and honorary treasurer, Dr. Vijay Chinchole, to present the next session, that is release of e-warrior cards.
Thank you, Dr. Hemant. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yes,
ma'am. Am I audible clearly?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
yes, you are. Can Dr. Bhakti also will be able to speak? Dr. Vijay, can you please check?
Yeah, she can speak.
She can, right? You can unmute her, please.
She's unmuted.
Yeah, thank you. Respected branch president, Dr. Vandana Daktore, honorable national leader, Dr. Mangesh Patel, honorable branch secretary, Dr. Hemant Patel, Dr. Vijay Chinchole, Dr. Bhakti Lote, president-elect, Dr. Neeti Upasani, Dr. Vijay Lakshmi Shinde, the cultural committee team, our managing committee members, branch members, colleagues, and friends. Today on this auspicious occasion of Guru Purnima, and as a part of the Atma Samman Divas, which we are celebrating to commemorate Doctors' Day, we would like to salute the branch COVID warriors, that is our members who have actively contributed in this fight against COVID-19 by providing expertise in and clinical skills in conducting fever OPDs, community clinics, and an IPD treatment of patients at COVID hospitals in Dombivli. In spite of the initial fears and apprehension of the unknown enemy, that is the COVID virus, our branch members stood in support to the call and appeal by the local KDMC authorities for the benefit of the community and as a part of a social and moral obligation to the local citizens. Each of them, be it from any medical field, put their best foot forward, overcoming personal and family hurdles. I'm sure we will all remember these days and moments for a long time to come with a sense of achievement. We are proud of our branch, IMA Dombivli, and our branch warriors. As a mark of respect and appreciation, we would like to release the e-cards. Dr. Bhakti Lote, President-elect, Dr. Vijay Chinchole, Honorary Treasurer, have meticulously looked into this project, and I would now like to call upon Dr. Bhakti to share her project details. Thank you very much.
Madam, can you hear us? Madam, can you continue till Bhakti Madam comes?
Bhakti Madam is there already. Can you unmute her?
Okay. No, she's... Hello, Madam.
I would like to state here that these cards are basically personalized e-cards. These will be serving as mementos for our life. We have members who were initially quite apprehensive about the PPE. We, all of us, were about the PPEs. So members have sent their photographs with their normal pictures and pictures in PPE, along with their experiences of while they were working in this pandemic. So these cards are basically for us, our branch, to express the salute and to show our solidarity and a pride for their contribution. So I would respect all members who haven't sent their cards, their data to the team, to please send a photograph, a normal picture, a picture of yours in PPE kit, along with a small write-up of your experience. These cards, you can share it on your media, that is Facebook, WhatsApp, and other media. And this is a token of appreciation from the branch. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam. I'll be sharing few cards which you have received the photographs with. These are excellent memories for all of us who have contributed in this war. that we have faced such a pandemic ever. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, friends, this comes to the conclusion of our today's program. Our first online meeting, which we are held for in IIM Dombivli due to the current scenario, of and we have to follow social distancing norms. I think we can improve day by day in this online meetings also. There were few hitches initially, but I think we can definitely improve in coming programs. Friends, there are a lot of programs in pipeline by the team of MPH, cultural team, HBI team. Please be attentive in our groups. I'll be putting all the details soon. I take an opportunity to thank President Madam Dr. Vandana Daktode and all our past presidents, Dr. Mangesh Pate, our national leader, Dr. Archana Pate, chairperson, IIM COVID Task Force, a platform, video meet platform, and all our respected members who joined the meeting and made it a huge success. Thank you, everyone. And we'll see you all soon in our next project, which I will be updating. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Hemant.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Hemant, and thank you, all members.
Thank you.
Thank you, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
Stay safe. Bye. Be healthy. Bye.
Okay, be healthy, all of you. Thank you.
Vijay, can you unmute everyone now? Is it possible now or still not possible because it is a webinar mode?
No, if webinar
mode. Unmute is not possible.
Not possible,
not possible at all.
It is not. No, they have to log in as a panelist.
Okay, fine. Because okay. Otherwise, yeah. Once the meeting is adjourned, they could have shared their queries or talks or small chat. See, you know what we usually do post meeting.
They have this question mark sign. They can talk, but they can put the question mark thing.
They can raise a hand also.
Yeah, but that is not as good as talking post meeting.
Yeah.
Either then like we try conference mode once. You know. For this
it was just a query, like we all are so
Tuesday when we are doing this HBI, it is conference or webinar?
It's a webinar.
Okay, similar.
So, should we try conference or no? Because there'll be too much disturbance then, right?
Yeah, because everybody's mic will be on.
We are used to having a lot of noise post meeting otherwise and missing that noise.
Hello. Still hello. 26 25 members are logged in.
Yeah. I think they can hear us, but we are friends, we all are missing you very badly. Yes. And weather is nice. It would have been a great opportunity to meet over the glass of vodka, a cup of coffee and pakoda in Dombivli Gymkhana or wherever we would have been till next time. And we will have a grand program. It will be like conclusion of all the meetings which we are missing otherwise. I think Vandana wants to put in more words to those who are listening.
Yes, you know, I'm really missing meeting everyone. You know, the selfie stands, you know, and all that delicious food and handshakes and hugs. And
now it is namaste, Indian way. Namaste is the new way, or it is the old way which is back in new
Yes.
How many are still logged in, Hemant?
21.
Yeah, 21.
Still 21. There are some chats if someone just sees.
Yeah, but Telugu sir is asking audience, some of the audience should be unmuted to express. That is a lacuna in this app, I think.
So let us try conference mode, I think, once.
I think once we can try.
No. This cannot be converted to conference mode now.
No.
It is not possible.
What we'll do, we'll unmute everyone in the conference mode. For the next meeting, and let us see how it works.
But that will be, I don't think if everyone will be unmuted, na, it will be chaos.
Chaotic.
Yeah, chaotic.
Or we can make certain more panelists can be added in more number.
No, but till we try it, see Vijay, till we try it, how we'll know it?
No, we should suggest to the person who has made this.
On the chatting, Deka has sent the message, and if anybody want to talk, we can provide the panelist code.
No, that is not possible. Like, how many panelist codes can you give?
Yeah.
No,
I think we should suggest this person, whoever has made this app, that the easy conversion from webinar to conference mode should be at one or two clicks away. So that is a suggestion which we can give. They may come up with something, because these are trial and error. What even we are doing, so it will be better if we can do that. Hope everyone is healthy, doing well. We are missing everyone.
Yes,
but missing shopping and dressing up. dress codes, having dress codes.
And no, we are learning to live as a, there is that community called as minimalist community, and a few of our members are already like minimalist. Sheetal believes in minimalism. Sheetal Kismat Rao.
Yeah.
And okay. We are inadvertently following Sheetal.
Yes.
And the moment this phase is over, we will be back to our shopping spree.
Yes.
I think there are 15 participants still logged in, including we 6 or 7.
Yeah.
Yes.
Vandana, shall we?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Have a great day. Thank you. Good night. Stay
healthy.
Goodbye.
Yes.
Yeah. Bye. Bye.